Hello students, welcome to this session. I am Anamika, your bio teacher, and today I am here with the chapter 7, that is cell structure and function. Students, in this video mainly we will read about the cell. That means what is cell, what is that means that how it discovered, who discovered the cell first of all. So that means all things about this. So let's start first. That means what is cell? Actually students, the cell that comes from the Latin word cellula, which means a small compartments or room. You can see this picture boys. This is the, that means the structure of the cork cell, which appears like, that means a small compartments or room. So let's see that what is the definition of the cell. We can say that cell is the basic, structural, functional and fundamental unit of life. All living things, they are composed of cell. That means either they are plants, animals, humans and microorganisms. Even the microorganisms, either they are unicellular or multicellular, simple or complex. Any organisms, they are composed of cell. Cell is the building block unit of life. Students, you can see here, that means one puzzle game is here and students are that means trying to complete it. And when it has been completed, it is the panda. So that means the every unit that is important. So that means like this puzzle, our body or the body of the plants, any animals, they are also made up of cell. In human body, that means trillion of cells are present. That means we can say that all living organisms, they are composed of cell. That means cell is the basic structural unit of life. Along with the structural, it is functional and fundamental unit of life. Students, I have discussed already these terms. Okay, do you know that who discovered cell first of all? And the student, credit goes to Robert Hooke. So Robert Hooke in 1665 first of all discovered the cell, but that was a dead cell. He observed thin slice of cork that is a part of the bark of the tree, and that was a dead cell. So he observed that cell under the self-designed microscope. And he observed, that means a structure like this, beehive or honeycomb like a structure. But that was a empty. Empty cell, that means it does not contain nucleus, because that is a dead cell. So the experiment of the Robert Hooke is very useful, because he was the first person who discovered cell first of all. And do you know students that he is called the father of cytology? So might be one question comes in your mind, that what is cytology? So let's see. So students, what is cytology? That is the branch of science which deals with the study of cell. A study of cell, that means the everything about the cell, either their structure, function, reproduction. Okay, so that means that branch is called cytology, and Robert Hooke is known as the father of cytology. And he wrote one book, and the name of the book is Microphagia, in which, that means he written everything about his experiments, that what he has done, how he discovered the cork cell. Next question that comes in your mind is student, that who discovered a living cell? Dead cell was discovered by the Robert Hooke, but who was the first who discovered the living cell? The credit goes to his students, Leeuwenhoek, Anton von Leeuwenhoek. In 1674, he discovered the bacterial cell while he was performing some experiments with the pond water. Do you know that he is also called the father of microbiology? He is also termed as the first microscopist and microbiologist. He was a Dutch scientist and businessman also. So that means those who first of all discovered the living cell. That was the bacteria, and after that various cell has been discovered. So students, so might be one question comes in your mind, that what is microbiology? So the microbiology, that is the branch of science which deals with the study of microorganisms. Microorganisms, that means the very tiny organisms which can't be observed by the naked eye. So the special instrument that is used for observing the microorganisms structure, that is microscope. Okay, so that means students, I think that whatever the topic that I have discussed, that should be clear to all of you. And do you have any doubt, you can ask, that means in the classes, in the Zoom classes. In our next video, we will study about the cell theory and the different types of the microscope. Okay, thank you.